नेता हार्दिक अभिनंदन और धन्यवाद। कार्यक्रम कसुम आरंभ जो है गीत के माध्यम से हम करेंगे और मैं छात्रों को और श्रीदेव रेदास सर को मंच पर आमंत्रित करता हूं कि आप आए और अपने मधुरमय संगीत से सभी को बोलें। श्रीमान वर्षा
illustrious leaders like Srimati Indira Gandhiji, Morarji Desai Ji, along with various esteemed governors of the state, has always been a source of inspiration for us. Today, we are thrilled to have His Excellency, Lieutenant General Vaibhava Trivikram Parnaik, PVSM, UYSM, YSM retired Honorable Governor of Arunachal Pradesh, as our chief guest. Your presence here adds a special significance to our gathering, and we are eager to hear your valuable insights. To have with us one of our alumnus, today's guest of honor, Sri Wamke Wangji, Honorable Minister, PHWS, TOTCL, Arunachal Pradesh. Your contributions to the state are commendable, and we look forward to your enlightening words, sir. We are also overwhelmed with joy as we have amongst us today the DC Tirap, the SP Tirap, Secretary to the Governor and other dignitaries present at this august gathering. Today's gathering exemplifies the spirit of unity, progress and cooperation We are grateful to all our distinguished guests and participants for being a part of this memorable occasion. Maharaj, Secretary Ramakrishna Narottam Nigar to present the welcome address for you.
Let noble thoughts come to us from all directions. My salutations to Honorable Governor, Lieutenant Governor Kaivalya Gurukam Public Sahib, to Sri Vanki Ji, to all other guests, including Sri Hankar Kaka, DCP Rao, Rahul Gupta, SP Rao, B.S. Bhaskar, Secretary to the Governor, and Swami Prabhasaran, the head of our Dibrugarh Center, the monks, teachers, our many alumni are here, managing committee members are here, some guests have come different places, and our very dear boys. You know, always we say this is a very important day. Today we have three programs. The concluding of the Golden Jubilee celebration of Ramakrishna Mission Narottam Nagar. The second is the worldwide 125 years of Ramakrishna Mission that Government of India has also taken great initiative, particularly Amit Shahji. That concluding actually will happen in the moment, but we are having our chapter today. And third, today the very special day. Why Honorable Governor has taken all this trouble is today the Universal Brotherhood Day. The day on which Swami Vivekananda delivered a famous lecture in Chicago. And so that day we thought it would be very special. Otherwise we could have done a very convenient day. Governor has taken so much of trouble but he has come. Sir, we have no words to thank you. As you all know, Universal Brotherhood Day. And we are paying to know the calamity that has happened in Morocco. Thousands of people have died by that earthquake. So in solidarity with them, in this Universal Brotherhood Day, can I request all of you to have a minute's prayer so that those who departed, they rest in peace. And those who are there, their pains are reduced. Can you please stand in reverence to them and pray for them? I just wanted to let our Honorable Governor know how privileged I am feeling myself. I remember once it was Dr. J.B. Patnaik, the Governor of Assam, he was telling, Swamiji, I am so privileged. I was there in the centenary celebrations of Swami Vivekananda. I was there in 125 celebrations of Swami Vivekananda. And I am here today during 150 years of Swami Vivekananda's birth anniversary. I was feeling so lucky. That what a fortunate time I have come to Narottam Nagar. That few years back I was in Shillong and there it was Diamond Jubilee celebration. And when I got transferred to Arunachal, my luck is this. Upcoming time then when we are having this Golden Jubilee celebration. If there is no Golden Jubilee, perhaps we won't have got Amit Shahji to come last year. Who is going to come to a small school like ours? Why Kiran Mituji and all? Yes, I understand Indira Gandhi. Vivekiri, Murat Desai, all of them have come those days because we started. But this is important, very special year for all of us. And long, since long we are having this problem, it was a public thoroughfare, this road, now this Vivekananda mark has come out. Amit Shahji unveiling the statue where he also offered flowers today. And our Chaunaman ji unveiling the statue of Bhagavan Buddha few months back on the other side of the road. And some of the buildings fortunately were being able to bring up so that our sufferings will be reducing. Our government, particularly government of Pema Khandu and his cabinet, are very supportive. They respond and you'll be very happy to know that this very year we have got two teachers, one is in Assam Awadi and another is State Awadi. When our students do not come the top 10 of Arunachal Pradesh, exams. And I am so happy that to your right is an alumnus of Narottam Nagar. Even your back, where you are also an alumnus. as in everywhere, you know, this is Alokas.
Why I am saying this is sir, perhaps you remember the story of Mahabharata, when this Gandhara is going to be killed, and few people, the Sakuni was made to leave. We need to have some centers of excellence. If little bit of investment from the government of India would produce a 1 kilowatt after some years, it is worth investing. I will not utilize because it's here. Unless our leaders stick to their culture, to their roots, to their religion, that's a demographic change. We are losing a lot. Wangiji and many others were here because they have tried to stick to their values, to their religious root, to their core. That is why the people here are having a much better life. They are having much more Indianness, much more belongingness to this country. There is a long story how this very center, without why I was pressurizing you almost to come this day, that whatever name we want the government to come, Golden Jubilee year. This center all that started without the intervention of the governor. Arunachal and study here. We will have that quality. Yes, we hope you understand, and we have no words to say you, express you all that is you. The whole day, even today morning, when I came to know that Sarvajit Secretary is coming, I was so happy because it gives that you are giving so much importance to this function. Even though the last functions we did in tents, it was very costly. So this time we are having in this hall, and fortunately our convention hall last time government has given foundation will come up and have a better hall next time, not that hot. And maybe we will be wishing to see you again and again. My respect to salutation to all of you, all the guests, and all of you welcome very well. Warm welcome. It is hot, but not that hot welcome. I give you a warm welcome. Thank you. Namaskar.
Atithi Devo Bhava. Arthat. अतिथि देवता के रूप होते हैं।
That shapes the character, caliber, and future of an individual and court. May I now request our Principal Swami Gyanandaji to present Golden Jubilee Report 2020-2023. Maharaj, please.
Golden Jubilee celebrations of Ramakrishna Mission Narottam Nagar. Report of activities undertaken during the celebrations from 2020 to 2023. Started in 1971, Ramakrishna Mission's branch at Narottam Nagar is one of the most acclaimed residential schools in Arunachal Pradesh. The plan of celebration commenced as early as October 2020, but the whole world was reeling under the pressure of COVID-19. It was postponed for a later date. On 21st of February, a virtual meet for the alumni of Ramakrishna Mission Narottam Nagar was held. On 3rd of October, a special worship of Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna was performed because that was the 50th day, means 1971, October 3rd, it was, the foundation stone was laid by the then, means Lieutenant Governor, later on, he became the first Lieutenant Governor of Arunachal. C.K. Raja, he laid the foundation stone. In Itanagar, the consultative meeting with the alumni of Itanagar region was held. On 17th of May, special ex gratia was provided to staff members. The total expense incurred was around 11 lakh rupees. On 18th May, a special get together for monastics who worked over here all those 50 years was organized. Around 50 monastics took part in that one. And on 19th and 20th of May, the combined Uttar Purvanchal Ramakrishna Vivekananda Bhava Prachar Parishad conference was held. On 20th of May, an alumni meet was held. Around 500 alumni took part in the function. The celebration was formally inaugurated on May 21st, 2022 by Sri Amit Shah, Honorable Union Home Minister. Other ministers who joined him in the celebration are Sri Kiran Rijiju, Union Minister for Law and Justice, Sri Pema Khandu, Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh, Sri Chawna Main, Deputy Chief Minister, Sri Kapil Gao, Member of Parliament, State Cabinet Minister, Sri Baman Felix, Sri Vanki Luwan, and others. Sri Amit Shah gifted a few cows, laid the foundation stone for new hostel buildings, and released special documentary video and commemorative souvenir. Sri Pema Khandu, Chief Minister, declared the new diversion road by the side of which the statue of Swami Vivekananda has been unveiled as Vivekananda Marg. The public meeting on 22nd May, a day long Bhakta Sammelan was organized. Around 1600 devotees from Assam and Arunachal joined. On 9th of July, a special puja to Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna and Sadhu Bhandara was held at our headquarters Ramakrishna Mutt, Belur Mutt, situated at West Bengal. On 23rd January, the second phase of Golden Jubilee celebrations was held. Sri Chawna Main, Deputy Chief Minister, Swami Subhirananji, General Secretary of our order, and others took part in the function. Around a gathering of 3,000 people, including monks from different parts of Northeast, Bhantes from Assam and Arunachal took part. Special activities under Golden Jubilee celebration, Ajadika Amrit Mahotsav under caravan and enrollment on the 75th year of Indian independence. Nagar, we have planted 1,000 saplings in the month of August 2021 under Know Your National Heroes. On 14th of November, a theatrical performance was staged by 55 students on the theme Prabuddha Bharat. Golden Jubilee Award creation. Silver Jubilee Award was merged with Golden Jubilee Fund and a new Golden Jubilee Award was created. Infrastructural development during the celebration period. The construction and inauguration of the below mentioned structures during Golden Jubilee celebration was held. A Kali statue at Devabhoomi Temple on 4th November in presence of Sri Vanki Luwan, Honorable Minister of PHWS. Statue at Vivekananda Marg on 21st May by Sri Amit Shah, Honorable Minister of Home Affairs. Bhagavan Buddha statue at Vivekananda Marg on 23rd January by Sri Chawna Main, Deputy Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh. During Golden Jubilee celebrations, the following projects have been conceived and some are in, means already the work has been begun and some are in, means in the planning phase. Two numbers, it's almost nearing completion. One boys hostel, 120 beds at secondary section, work is going on. One boys hostel, 60 beds at higher secondary section. It is conceived a foundation stone, Ramakrishna Mission Sarada Vidyalaya. A new convention hall with 800 seats. These are planned and will be executed after the celebration period. Awards and achievements during the Golden Jubilee period. Ramakrishna Mission was selected for the State Golden Medal for its service activities. He was awarded the National Teachers Award by the President of India, Srimati Draupadi Murmu, on 5th September 2022. Sri Devasis Roy was awarded the State Best Teachers Award by the Chief Minister of Arunachal Pradesh, Sri Pema Khandu, on 5th September 2023. Four students, Gridham Kami, Master Tomi Nadu, Tona Hutto, Tony Nadu, were selected for Dera Nadu Award for securing state ranks in CBSE Class 12 Exam 2021. One student, Master Tiffan Kusya, was selected for Sangi Varan Award for securing state level rank 4 in CBC Class 10 exam. Two students, Tiffan Kusya and Kundan Tikin, were selected for State Merit Scholarship Award 2023. Four students, Nogdom Mankam Chomkai Vankan Chokkam Munsu. Three students cracked NMMS, National Means Come Merit Scholarship exam. Cracked nearest NEE1 exam. And five students got admitted during the celebration period. Five students got admitted in IIT, three got admitted in NIT, one got admitted in Indian Institute of Information Technology, IIIT. Golden Jubilee Day ourselves, distributed around 736 blankets in Lapna, Namsang and Borduria villages. Golden Jubilee medical camp. Medical camps have been organized. Many specialist doctors have come and around 222 patients have been treated. Golden Jubilee games and sports. Games like football, volleyball, basketball, cricket, table tennis tournaments were conducted and prizes were awarded for the winners. Golden Jubilee celebration. Under in-school sports program of Arunachal Pradesh, training of the students in table tennis commenced from February 2023. We make Vikas an all-round development program for the children belonging to the poor and marginalized sections of society has commenced on 27th January 2023. As of now, 50 students are in its row. About thanks, we are grateful to our local administration, state and central governments, various corporates, houses, as well as to our friends and relatives scattered all over the country and above for their help and support in various ways over the years. So, Bhagavan Sri Ramakrishna, Ma Sarada Devi and Swami Vivekananda Shabaram are is our great prayers. Thanks, Sarvam.
धन्यवाद प्रधानाचार्य महाराज जी, आपने हमारे विद्यालय हमारे संस्था के ऐतिहासिक योगदान और स्वर्णिम वर्ष में आयोजित समारोह का सार हमारे सामने प्रस्तुत किए। अब कार्यक्रम को आगे बढ़ाते हुए मैं हमारे लोकप्रिय जननायक माननीय मंत्री श्री वंकी लोन पीएचई डब्ल्यूएस डीओ टीसीएल मंत्री अरुणाचल प्रदेश आपसे सादर निवेदन करना चाहूंगा कि आप हमारे प्रतिष्ठित विद्यालय के विजेताओं को अपने कर कमलों से सम्मानित करें। श्रीमान सर्वप्रथम श्री निताय चंद्रदेव नेशनल टीचर अवार्ड 2023 देवाशीष रॉय स्टेट टीचर अवार्ड 2023 तालियों की गणना होनी चाहिए। मास्टर तेफान घोसिया स्टेट ऑफ क्लास के डेरा ग्रामीण अवार्ड स्टेट फोर्थ रैंक होल्डर इन सीबीएसई क्लास के धन्यवाद श्रीमान जी। अब मैं हमारे लोकप्रिय जननायक मंत्री जी से सादर निवेदन करता हूं कि आप सभा को संबोधित करें। श्रीमान
our honorable governor lieutenant general K.T. Karnaik BBSM UYSM YSM retired secretary maharaj of this institution the principal maharaj and all the honesty members teachers and all the guys our deputy commissioner secretary to governor SP Tiram and all the officers present here, the panchayat leaders, the jila parishad members from Soha block, Deomali block, and the cultural troop, media friends, and in fact, of course, my student friends. We are immensely happy to have our honorable governor amidst us, in spite of a speculation of his visit due to the weather conditions. So I just have to console him, telling him that Swamiji, please don't worry. Pray to Thakurji, Sri Ramakrishna, everything will be okay. And then everything will happen. And we are really happy. And see the activities, the receptions, the prayers, the dining halls, everything. It takes me back to 50 years. I was also here as a similar student, and I hope that my frequent attendance here in Narottam Nagar will help me to prolong my age and help me to remain younger, because my childhood, whenever I come here, I have very good reminiscences of my childhood. My special congratulations to the two teachers who have received award from the state government and from the government of India, and also the students. I congratulate the students who have received Dera Natung Award today, and the rest is a history in the making for the future, and of course being made for entire Arunachal. This institution has been catering and serving the entire state from the east to the west, and of this institution in different positions or different capacities. I hope this institution will continue to give and serve this people of Arunachal Pradesh and help to build a healthy, a patriotic, and a developed society, that it will continue to contribute for the welfare of the state. And with these few words, I thank Swamiji for giving me this opportunity, and I thank especially our Honorable Governor for coming here, for giving us his valuable time. In fact, we had a mind, if there was a time, we were all the Jamali people, the people of Tirap district, people of 54 Namsa, were having a plan to give you a better reception and interaction with the people, but due to time constraint, this could not happen. I hope the next visit you will give us more time so that our people also can interact with you. Thank you.
Thank you, Minister Sri Ramki Ramji, for your valuable observation, sir. Now, awarding of scholarships, may I request our today's chief guest, Lieutenant General Sri Koivalya Pradeep Parmar, BDSM, EYSM, YSM retired, Governor of Arunachal Pradesh, to give away the prizes to our students. I will call the name. About Pansa of class 5 will collect for two students 5,000 each, total amount 2,000. Thank you. So, class 6 will collect for two students of 5,000 each, total amount 10,000 only. Next, so Yeshi Nardu of class 7 will collect for two students 5,000 each, total amount 10,000 students only. Next, Sri Yaksan Nopa of class 8 will collect for two students, it is 5,000 each, with an amount to be 10,000 only. The class 9, Choklong Wangsu will collect from 4 students 7,000 each, total amount of 8,000 only. Next, Nongja Bangsia of class 8 will collect for 4 students 7,000 each, total amount of 28,000 only. Next, Devon Prussia of class 11 will collect for 2 students. And Devon Kanga of class 12 will collect for 3 students 10,000 each, total amount 30,000 only. This was IPTI Bank Golden Jubilee Scholarship for 2023-24, classes 5 to 12. May I now request Martin Babin of class 9 to collect Infosys Foundation Scholarship 2023-24, given to class 9 to class 12. We will collect for 12 students 15,000 each, total amount 1,80,000 only. Rodi Hai of class 10 will collect from 13 students 15,000 each, total amount 1,95,000 only. Next, Wamsin Lamati of class 11 will collect for 7 students 15,000 each, total amount 1,05,000 only. And Zhao Kui Ong Sikang, 20,000 to the total amount, 1,20,000 only. Thank you.
धन्यवाद श्रीमान. अब मैं हमारे आज के मुख्य अतिथि लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल श्री कैवल्य त्रिविक्रम पन्नाय TVSF, UYSF, YSF, retired Honorable Governor of Arunachal Pradesh. Shriman, आपसे सादर निवेदन है कि आप सभा को संबोधन करें. Shriman.
Honorable Minister of Public Health Engineering and Water Supply Department, Thirap, Changlang and Longding, Sri Wangki Loa, Deputy Commissioner, Thirap District, Sri Hento Karna Ji, Superintendent Police, Sri Rahul Gupta Ji, Secretary Ramakrishna Mission, Narottam Nagar, Swami Achyuteshanand Ji, Secretary Ramakrishna Mission, Deputy Swami Videsha Ranand Ji, Principal Ramakrishna Mission, Narottam Nagar, Swami Jinayananda Ji, esteemed monks, teachers, students, staff, and my beloved friends here. I am also pleased here to be with you today despite some early hiccups when the weather was playing little drought. However, the gods were kind, as the Honorable Minister mentioned, that they were praying to the Lord, so was I. And I was very sure that I'll make it. I even told the minister that if it did not happen, I would come by road one day. Ramakrishna Mission schools in Arunachal are the torch bearers. You are the leading light in this state, and you have set gold standards for others to emulate. I am extremely pleased because I recently had a visit to the Ramakrishna Mission School in Gundu. I am here today, and soon I will visit the school in Palu also. I must say, having seen your premises, having seen the dedication of the monks and the teachers, having seen the enthusiasm of the students here, I am very certain that the kind of quality education you are getting here is going to make you extremely good citizens and leaders of tomorrow. एक बात जो मेरे ध्यान में आई है कि आपकी जो शिक्षा प्रणाली है रामकृष्ण मिशन स्कूल में उसके पीछे एक शक्ति भाव का बहुत प्रभावशील भाग है। और मैं बाकी प्रांतों में जब स्कूलों में जाता हूँ, यूनिवर्सिटीज में जाता हूँ, तो उनके लिए मेरा एक ही गुरु मंत्र है, वो है शिक्षा का सार क्या होना चाहिए। शिक्षा का सार होना चाहिए शिक्षित, अनुशासित और प्रेरित, और ये तीनों गुण मुझे यहाँ के बच्चों में नजर आते हैं। आई कॉम्प्लीमेंट यू ऑल। आई ऑल्सो विश टू कॉम्प्लीमेंट रिस्पेक्टेड टीचर्स हु हैव वन नेशनल अवार्ड्स एंड द स्टेट अवार्ड्स एंड दे हैव बीन रिसेंटली ऑनर्ड। I am immensely pleased and be blessed to be a part of this sacred gathering today, celebrating the 50th Golden Jubilee of the institution. I am overwhelmed by the presence of enlightened monks, dedicated teachers, devoted staff members and brilliant students who represent the future of our great nation. As we know that we are celebrating the Azadi Ka Amrit Kaal as enunciated by our beloved Prime Minister Shri Modi ji, it is you students who would be there to celebrate this Amrit Kaal 25 years from hence. I see in this crowd many leaders, many engineers, doctors, professors and eminent people who will come back to this institution when the Amrit Kaal comes near in 2047, and then feel proud to have been a part and parcel of this school. It's a great feeling. Honorable Minister was also reminiscing about his time in school, and I agree with him that every time you come to your alma mater, you always feel younger and younger and younger. Who once said, let new India arise from groves and forests, from hills and mountains. Now these words are resonating deeply in the state of Arunachal Pradesh and in your district, where you are creating and nurturing education in the way it should be. And the result would obviously be seen 10 years, 15 years from now. Vivekananda, and I'm sure that New India, which rises above all challenges, nurtures the innate talents of these people and embraces the values of love, tolerance and brotherhood. When you talk of brotherhood, none can be more affiliated, affected and adopted with this word than the one who serves in the armed forces. I can tell you that we have a supreme brotherhood in the armed forces, and it is institutionalized by a simple small sentence, one for all for one. You are very fortunate to be living in these salubrious surroundings, deep, lovely forests all around you. All greenery, no pollution, fresh air and wonderful teaching staff to guide you. We have seen remarkable progress in Arunachal in the last few years, especially in the field of education, healthcare, infrastructure development as well as sports. However, we must remember that progress should not come at the cost of environment or cultural heritage of our indigenous communities. We must strive to sustain development that preserves our natural surroundings and treasures them, at the same time respects the diversity of our tribes and our people. As we gather here today, let us pledge to work towards a new India, an India where every child has access to quality education, healthcare, and which is a right and not a privilege, and where spirit of brotherhood transcends all boundaries. The journey may be long and challenging, but as Swami Vivekananda said, arise, awake, and stop not until the goal is reached. In conclusion, I would like to say that I am greatly pleased to be here amongst the students and amongst the school, and I am greatly influenced and greatly impressed by the way you are being brought up. A lot of good sense has been prevailing here, and under the teachings of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa as well as Swami Vivekananda, there are so many quotes and quotations that I keep coming across every day. I would like to quote a few of them. "Be not afraid of anything" was the first thing he said. "Nirbhay." I think as you grow up from childhood to adulthood and then become more responsible people, this is one thing which must always, if you are right, if you have done no wrong, you do not have to fear at all. Don't fear of consequences, don't fear of results. You have moral courage to accept responsibility, that is what is growth. He also said, we are what our thoughts have made us. So take care about what you think, conquer yourself, and the whole universe is yours. There are many much more such quotes which are so aptly applicable to your school and this environment. At the end, I would once again like to thank Swamiji. I would like to thank the monastic representation here, the staff, and also like to convey my deep appreciations to all the students who have been here, and I'm sure you've been waiting since morning. We have been delayed because of the weather, but then that's how it is. At the end of it, I wish you good luck, I wish you Godspeed, and I'm sure in times to come this school will produce many luminaries who will be not only good citizens but good leaders for our state and the health for our country. Thank you very much. Jai Arunachal, Jai Hind.
अब मैं धन्यवाद ज्ञापन हेतु
ऊर्जा से भरपूर स्वामी वेदसानंद जी महाराज, सचिव रामकृष्ण मिशन डिब्रूगढ़। महाराज जी, आपसे विनम्र निवेदन करता हूं कि आप कार्यक्रम में उपस्थित प्रत्यक्ष और अप्रत्यक्ष रूप से सभी का आभार व्यक्त करें। महाराज,
सर्वे सन्तु निरामया, सर्वे भद्राणि पश्यन्तु, मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् भवेत्। आज के इस पुण्य दिन में, जिसको हम विश्व भातृत्व दिवस के रूप में मनाते हैं, पूरे विश्व में धीरे धीरे इसकी प्रथा शुरू हो रही है, इस अवसर पर विशेष करके गोल्डन जुबली की इस पर्व की समापन अवसर पर भी आज अति उत्कृष्ट महत्वपूर्ण अवसर पर हमारे बीच उपस्थित हुए श्रीमान लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल केटी परनायक जी, आदरणीय गवर्नर गवर्नमेंट ऑफ अरुणाचल प्रदेश, उनका हम हृदय से आभार ज्ञापन करते हैं, धन्यवाद ज्ञापन करते हैं कि वे अपने अति व्यस्त जीवन में से समय निकालकर हम लोगों के बीच में आकर उपस्थित हो रहे हैं और हमारे सारे बच्चों को इसी तरह से प्रेरित किए हैं अपने वचनों के माध्यम से, ये बता के कि हमारा जो ये संस्था है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ अरुणाचल के लिए और अरुणाचल प्रदेश का एक आदर्श संस्थाओं में से एक है, आदर्श शिक्षा संस्था के हम लोगों ने एक प्रतिष्ठा प्राप्त किया है, उसको जो है हमारे सामने रखे हैं। साथ में आज हम लोगों ने जो हमारे प्रिंसिपल महाराज जी के माध्यम से ये देखा है कि हमारे बच्चों के सारे पास किए हुए, कोई IIT में गए, NIT में गए, तो मैं सोच रहा था तो आज गवर्नर महोदय ने हमारे बच्चों के लिए, आप लोगों के लिए एक दूसरा आदर्श दिया है। वो एक सेक्टर है जहां में नियम वर्तिता है, डिसिप्लिन्ड है, वो है आम पुरुष। आने वाले दिनों में मैं ये विश्वास करता हूं कि अब उस लिस्ट में सर NDA का भी नाम आना चाहिए। सर, हम सबके लिए एक आदर्श रूप में है आज, आज हमको सारे बच्चों के लिए यह आदर्श बना दिया है कि ये भी एक हमारा जो है एक सेक्टर ऑफ अचीवमेंट होना चाहिए। उसके लिए भी मैं सर को हृदय से धन्यवाद देता हूं। साथ में उपस्थित है हमारी व्यक्ति, हमारे स्थान के व्यक्ति, जननेता श्रीमान वांगी लुआंग जी, हम लोग सुपरिचित हैं उनके संबंध में और आप लोगों ने उनको देश सुना ही है। बोलते हैं कि जितने बार मैं यहाँ पे आता हूं तो मुझे लगता है कि मैं और भी जो है युवा रूप में विकसित हो रहा हूं, तो जिस हिसाब से हम लोगों को सहायता करते हैं, सहयोग करते हैं, हमारे साथ में रहते हैं, हमारे साथ सोचते हैं, संस्था में जुड़े रहने को अपना जो है एक सम्मान समझते हैं, हम इसके लिए हृदय से धन्यवाद ज्ञापन करते हैं। साथ में आज जो उपस्थित इस सभा में DC, SP, गवर्नर जी के सेक्रेटरी और दूसरे डिग्निटरीज, गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स लोकल लेवल में जो टीचर्स और आप सारे हमारे युवा भाइयों, हमारे स्टूडेंट्स, उन सबको मैं संस्था की तरफ से धन्यवाद देता हूं कि आप लोग इतनी गर्मी में आके यहां पे हम सबका उत्साह वर्धन किए, उसके लिए हम हृदय से धन्यवाद देते हैं। पर अंत में मैं उनको अपने तरफ से हृदय से धन्यवाद करता हूं कि आने वाले समय में अरुणाचल गवर्नमेंट, वांगी लुआंग जी बैठे हुए हैं, सर बैठे हुए गवर्नर जी, कि ये हम देखें इतनी उत्कृष्ट टाइप की जो सेवा देने वाली संस्था जब है उसको पूर्ण तरह से सहयोग देकर ये विजन को हम फिर से प्रैक्टिफाई करें कि आने वाले 100 वर्षों में ये जो है पूरे इंडिया में एक उत्कृष्ट संस्था, शिक्षण संस्था के रूप में विकसित हो पाए। इस सभा में जितने भी हमारे मीडिया पर्सन आए हैं, हमारे जो स्टाफ्स हैं, करके आसपास के गांव के जो कन्याएं हैं, जो हमारी छोटी छोटी लड़कियां आके बहुत ही सुंदर तरह से प्रोग्राम को उन लोगों ने सुसज्जित किया है, उनको भी मैं आश्रम के तरफ से हृदय से धन्यवाद देता हूँ। मेरे भूलवशत या समय के अभाव के कारण मैं सारे उन लोगों को भी संस्था के तरफ से हृदय से धन्यवाद देता हूँ कि आप लोग आकर इस छोटी से प्रोग्राम को, बड़ी महत्वपूर्ण प्रोग्राम को, इसको बड़ी सुंदर से सुसज्जित किया है। धन्यवाद। जय भारत, जय अरुणाचल।
Thank you.